I like biology. I like understanding things at the molecular scale. I think microbes offer really interesting systems of study, because a lot of the fundamental mechanisms that bacteria use to live are exactly what humans use to live and plants use to live. And so I'm really interested in fundamental biological processes. And I'm also interested in how organisms interact with each other. And I think microbial host interactions are fascinating.
The moment I set foot in the lab, really my career was set, where I was just really engaged in trying to understand how these pathogens cause disease and how the immune response can protect ourselves against them. When I was thinking about what I wanted my research career to focus on in my own independence, I wanted to think about a pathogen that had a worldwide impact. And Mycobacterium tuberculosis, the pathogen that I work on, is the number one leading cause of death by infectious disease. And so what our research is really focused at is really thinking about distinct interactions between pathogen one and your host immune response, so that we can devise better strategies to amplify the immune response to protect them, whether that's through a new therapy or a vaccine approach. Thinking differently about immunity, not necessarily the effectors that are targeting the pathogens, but more holistically, how the immune response interacts with tissue function and regulation, and what happens if you can't clear those infections is equally as important and are things that we've contributed to over the last 10 years. So when you think about this new model system that we developed, which we call FLAMS, what it allows us to do is we can isolate cells and understand their function by themselves. We can genetically manipulate them. We can knock out genes. We can add genes back. We can then freeze them and study them long term. But then we can take these same cells and put them back into the lungs of an animal so that we can understand how they work alone and how they work within the lung environment together with the entire mouse.
I was really interested in pursuing research in the Olive Lab because I'm really interested in host-pathogen interactions, especially when it comes to mycobacterium species like those that cause the disease tuberculosis. And that's what our lab really focuses on, is understanding the foundational aspects of the interactions between the host and the pathogen.
It's important to have the facilities to do level three work, because Brucella abortus, one of the Brucella species that we work on, is a biosafety level three pathogen. And so for us to be able to develop Brucella abortus strains that are attenuated, that could potentially be moved forward as vaccines with our collaborators at the United States Department of Agriculture, we have to have the facilities to do the strain manipulation and develop those attenuated strains of Brucella abortus. Without those facilities, we're not going to be able to do the vaccine development work that we're doing in collaboration with the USDA. It's a real privilege to just be able to do this work and to learn more about how life works. And you hope that some of the discoveries that we make going forward are going to improve vaccines, lead to the development of new therapeutics, and really improve human and animal and plant well-being. But science is a slow process, you know, and advances are often small, and you never really know what is going to be a breakthrough and what's not going to be a breakthrough. And so I think it's important to support really fundamental work as we try to learn more about who we are, how we live, how life works.